गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास नाइन, लेट्स कंटिन्यू द सेम चैप्टर, दैट इज चैप्टर नंबर 12, स्केलेटन मूवमेंट एंड लोकोमोशन। सो फार इन दिस चैप्टर वी डिस्कस अबाउट द फंक्शंस ऑफ ह्यूमन स्केलेटन एंड देन फॉलोड बाय द कंस्टिट्यूएंट ऑफ स्केलेटन एंड देन आफ्टर दैट वी ऑल्सो डिस्कस अबाउट द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ बोन्स ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ देयर शेप्स एंड साइजेस। ओके, देन आफ्टर दैट वी ऑल्सो learn about the structure of the bone, okay, about the internal structure, external structure, about the types of bone marrow, yellow bone marrow, red bone marrow, okay, this all we have already discussed. Now comes the next topic, that is the human skeleton. Okay, page number 18 is there in your book. So today we'll be learning about human skeleton. In this video, we'll learn up to vertebral column. Okay, vertebral column will finish in this video. Now, human skeleton, the total number of bones that is present in human being or human skeleton consists of 206 bones, as you all know. Okay, then again, these 206 bones or the human skeleton is mainly categorized into two groups, axial and appendicular. Axial skeleton and appendicular skeleton. Axial skeleton includes the bones or the structure such as skull, which is also called as cranium, vertebral column, which is also called as backbone, and then ribs, and then comes sternum. Okay, then appendicular includes the limb bone. Limb bone means the bone of hands and legs, and then girdle bone. Girdle bone means the bone of shoulder, okay, and the bone of hip region. Now first we will start with axial skeleton, where we'll be learning first about the skull. As I told you, skull is also called as cranium. Now here it is mentioned that the upper top part consists of about 8 bones. And this skull also includes the facial bone, which consists of around 14 bones. Okay, we talk about the upper part, they are joined very tightly with each other and they cannot move at all. Okay, they are responsible for protecting the brain. Then the important term which we need to keep in our mind when we go through this topic is foramen magnum. Foramen magnum. Foramen magnum is the hole that is present at the base of the skull. This head region at the base of the skull at the back side, okay, hole is present. Through this hole, the spinal cord usually leaves or emerges out, okay, of the brain. That hole is called foramen magnum. Hole present at the base of cranium through which spinal cord emerges out. Okay, so this point you need to remember here. Then let us now understand about vertebral column, which is the second part of axial skeleton. Vertebral column, as I told you before, that it is also called as backbone. Okay, then again the next important point which we need to keep in your mind is there are around 33 ring-like structure. Okay, ring-like structure which are usually called as vertebrae. Okay, vertebrae is plural, vertebra is singular. Vertebrae is plural and vertebra is singular. Okay, 33 ring-like structures are present in the backbone, which we call as the vertebrae. This vertebral column can be categorized into 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 different groups, starting from the neck region up to the tail region. The neck, our neck, okay, consists of about 7 cervical vertebrae. Cervical vertebrae means those vertebrae which are present in the cervical region, that is in the neck region. Okay, ours 7 cervical vertebrae are there. Okay, even the giraffe also has 7 cervical vertebrae, though it is quite long. Yes or no? Even then, okay, the giraffe also consists of same number of cervical vertebrae. Then again, here about this cervical vertebrae, we need to keep in our mind one more important thing, that is the starting vertebrae, vertebra, the starting one, cervical starting vertebra is also called atlas, and the last vertebrae of the cervical vertebrae is what you call the axis, atlas axis. The first bone of cervical vertebrae is called atlas, and the last bone of cervical vertebrae is called axis. Okay, now atlas, whenever we say yes, okay, whenever we say yes, that time we use atlas to say yes. Then again, whenever to say no, we use the lowest part of the cervical vertebrae, that is axis. Okay, this way also you can remember the name. Then after that come thoracic vertebrae. Thoracic vertebrae, which is present in the thorax region. Thorax region means chest region. Okay, there are around 12 thoracic vertebrae. Then again comes lumbar. Okay, lumbar mostly in the abdomen region. Lumbar, around 8-5 lumbar vertebrae are there. Sacrum. Sacrum is mostly formed by the fusion of 4-5 vertebral vertebrae. Okay, then again the last part, that is the tail end of this vertebrae, is what you call the coccyx, which is mainly formed by the fusion of 3-5 vertebrae. Okay, so this is about the different types of vertebra, okay, which are usually present in vertebral column. Then again, now the main part, that is the structure of vertebra. Okay, if you just take out a single vertebra and if you observe now how many different structure we will be able to see. So what we see is that the part like centrum, it shows the part like neural canal, okay, through which the spinal cord usually runs, and again it consists of the part like transverse process up and down. Two transverse processes are present. Then again this transverse process encloses two neural arc, okay. Then again upward projecting structure called neural spine is also present. On the same transverse process, okay, articular facets are present. So one by one we'll be discussing about that. So the points which is to be included here, see, the first one comes centrum. Centrum is actually, see, solid cylindrical part. This is a solid cylindrical part of the vertebrae. This solid cylindrical part of the vertebrae, which is mainly present towards the ventral region, that is this way. Ventral region means this side, okay. Dorsal means back side, okay. And again back side, this projecting structure is present, that is neural spine. Okay, so the solid cylindrical part of the vertebrae, which we call as the centrum. Okay, now both of its end or the opposite ends, okay, are usually flat. So this is what we need to remember here. Then again dorsal to this centrum, that means back side, okay, towards the back side to this centrum, a hole is present, okay, a hollow cavity is present, which we call as the neural canal. Through this neural canal, spinal cord usually runs. Then again, this neural canal, it is mentioned that it is formed by the fusion of two spinal, this one neural arc, okay. Then after that comes longitudinal ridge, as I told you about the neural spine before. The longitudinal ridge projecting upward, okay, from the meeting point up to neural arc is what we call neural spine. Then again after that, the sideward projection, these two, the sideward projection from, you can say that neural canal, is what you call the transverse process. Then in the transverse process, okay, facets are present, okay, over which this one, what you call vertebral column, one after the other is placed. And this articulation means movement, okay. This has little bit movement of vertebral column, and then again this also provides a space over which the vertebral column are placed one over the other. So articular facets which have been joining the two vertebrae are given here. So this is about the structure of vertebra. Now after this we will study about ribs in the next video. Thank you, students.